ज्यादा महत्व दिया जाता है, तो टीम कैसे उसको देखती है आगे इंग्लैंड टूर पर?
मेरे ख्याल में जैसा विराट ने कहा, हर सीरीज में जो हमारे जो एंडेवर है वो सेम रहेगा। वी डोंट चेंज स्ट्रैटेजी जस्ट बिकॉज वी आर प्लेइंग अनदर ऑपोजिशन। हमारे लिए एन ऑपोजिशन इज एन अपोनेंट, और जो हमारे जो बेसिक्स है वी वुड लाइक टू इंप्रूव ऑन दैट। क्योंकि विच टीम डू यू रेट? यू रेट अ टीम दैट इज कंसिस्टेंट। सो आर एम इज टू स्ट्राइव फॉर कंसिस्टेंसी। जो लास्ट टूर था अच्छा था साउथ अफ्रीका का, द एम्फेसिस विल बी टू ट्राई एंड रिपीट दैट काइंड ऑफ कंसिस्टेंसी।
How much has that hampered or helped you in your preparations, keeping in mind the workload that you go through?
In hindsight, when I look at it now, I think what has happened was the best thing for me. Because although, yes, I wanted to go and experience the conditions, and that's a place that we haven't played so much. There's a big gap of 4 years, and you know, you sort of forget how the conditions were when you played last time. So I wanted the more difficult phase of those conditions. Now we're going to enter the heat wave. As I mentioned, it's going to be hotter. So I wanted the damp and the wet conditions, which you know Pujji played in and Ishant played in, and I saw Varun playing in as well. But in hindsight, when I look at it now, I mean, if I was 90% with my body and used to the conditions compared to feeling 110 now and you know going in fresh, I would much rather be in this position. Because in hindsight, when I thought of it, I thought, you know, I need to be fresh for the tour. I need to be looking forward to it rather than thinking, oh, I've been in that place for 4 months now, and you know you don't want that feeling because the test series is in the later half. So look, things are, they turn out to be in the best way that they can for you. And I think this thing that has happened was probably the best thing in hindsight now, although not intended, but it happened a certain way. And now, as I said, I'm very excited to be going on to the field again.
We'll be taking two more questions. Yes.
Shoot. Virat, swing jo hai generally Hindustani players ko dikkat karti rahi hai England mein. Iske season matlab mausam ko bhi raha ho. To uske liye hum log mentally kitne tayar hain?
अगर दूसरे प्लेयर्स को स्विंग या सीम तंग नहीं करती तो हम एक भी विकेट नहीं ले पाते दूसरी कंडीशंस में, या फास्ट बॉलर्स प्ले में ही नहीं आते। आप साउथ अफ्रीका सीरीज देखिए, हमने हर मैच में 20 विकेट लिए, तो स्पिनर्स ने कितने विकेट लिए उसमें से? तो दूसरी टीम भी, अगर आप अच्छी बॉलिंग करेंगे तो दूसरी टीम को भी दिक्कत होती है। पिछले बार जब हम खेले हैं तो हमें ऐसा फील हुआ कि हमने शायद कलेक्टिवली एज अ टीम दोनों या तीनों स्किल्स में अच्छा हमने कंसिस्टेंटली परफॉर्म नहीं किया। उस वजह से आपको एज अ बैटिंग यूनिट लगता है कि शायद आप पे ज़्यादा प्रेशर है, या बॉलर्स को लगता है कि शायद हम पे ज़्यादा प्रेशर है कि बैटिंग अच्छा नहीं कर रही है। लेकिन जब दोनों चीज़ें साथ में क्लिक करती हैं तो चाहे स्विंग हो, चाहे सीम हो, चाहे बाउंस हो, चाहे टर्न हो, अगर आपका टीम के पास मोमेंटम है तो कोई भी कंडीशन आसान लगती है। अगर मोमेंटम नहीं है तो फ्लैट पिच पे भी आपको मुश्किल लगेगा, सीधी बॉल भी लगता है कि स्विंग हो रही है। पर हाँ, कंडीशंस डिफरेंट हैं जरूर, और हमें उस चीज़ को रिस्पेक्ट करना होगा। जैसे रवि भाई ने बोला, हमारे पास समय बहुत है, तो वहाँ जाके हम बाय द टाइम टेस्ट सीरीज आएगी हम लोग इतने कंफर्टेबल हो चुके होंगे कि हमें लगेगा ही नहीं कि हम कोई अवे सीरीज खेलने जा रहे हैं। तो आई थिंक टाइम होने का एक ही फैक्टर होता है कि मेंटली आप एक जगह पे कंफर्टेबल हो जाते हैं, और वो सबसे बड़ा फैक्टर है। अगर आप मेंटली एट ईज हैं तो फिर आपकी परफॉर्मेंस भी दिखती है।
विराट, यू नो ऑब्वियसली इट्स अ टीम स्पोर्ट, बट यू आर द लीडर ऑफ दिस टीम एंड द प्लेयर्स डू लुक अप टू यू। द लास्ट टाइम यू टूर्ड इंग्लैंड इट वाजंट टू ग्रेट, बट यू नो मेंटली लाइक व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ अ जोन यू आर इन, एंड एज फार एज यू नो स्किल्स हैव आल्सो यू आर अ मच बेटर बैट्समैन एट दिस पॉइंट इन टाइम, ऑफ कोर्स व्हेन यू लास्ट टूर्ड इंग्लैंड। So individually, how what are your realistic goals, not in terms of the team result, but individually, because your performance does matter when it comes to the Indian team.
It's not only my performance. I think if I don't get runs in any of the games on the tour and someone else is getting 100 or 75, 80 every game, we still win. It's not that, you know, I have to score runs and 100 becomes 200. I mean, it's the same score. There's no difference as far as I see it. But yes, as the captain of the team, I like to put in performances myself. And I like to, you know, take the team along, take my teammates along, motivate them and boost them in any way possible. I think a lot of people have held on to the last tour for too long. I think we've had the Champions Trophy in between as well, which has totally been forgotten. I don't think it was in Bangladesh. So, I don't see the... I mean, I was asked this question when we reached England and they said, what are you looking forward to on this tour? I said, taking a walk and having coffee on the street. So, my thinking is very different when I go to a tour or go to a place. I literally am looking forward to enjoying the country. I'm not even thinking of the cricket right now because I know if I'm in a good zone, then I will play well. If I think like how people are thinking on the outside, I have to do well, then things don't happen because I have to go out there and face what's going to happen. So, look, as I said, concerned individually, but for us as a team, this is a very exciting time because what happened in South Africa has really, we're actually looking forward to playing more difficult test cricket after what happened in South Africa, and that I feel is the best thing that can happen to any side. You know, you don't want to go to England saying, oh, the test series is in 1 month. We want it to actually be sooner. So that's the kind of excitement we take along with us. So is the case with the ODI and the T20 team as well. So I think it's just a great phase for Indian cricket, and myself individually, all the players, and I think all the people concerned with Indian cricket should really be excited and be looking forward to enjoying it rather than, you know, putting individuals before team, which we certainly don't do. And I'm certainly very excited to be enjoying this time with the team.
Yeah, the final question. Hi Ravi. Hi Virat. I want to ask this to both of you. You talked of how, you know, it is about going out there. It's an exciting series, but it is also an important series in the context of where world cricket is right now, where you see some of the top teams not being able to perform well overseas. Keeping that in mind and, you know, just to, you know, make sure that the reputation of the Indian team of doing well abroad, keeping that in mind, how important is the series?
There's no away. Every game is home game. Because we don't play the opponent, we play the pitch. You know, our job is to conquer the pitch wherever we go. So it could be Bombay, it could be Delhi, it could be London, it could be Johannesburg. It is 22 yards that we have to try and conquer. And that is the endeavor. And the boys know that they'll be rated if they adapt to different conditions. So if the other team has to adapt to those conditions, so do we. So it's not a question of where you're playing. For us, every game has to be a home game. You see those 22 yards, you have to say, how am I going to take 20 wickets on those 22 yards? How am I going to score 350, 400? Keep it simple.
I just want to add to that a little bit as well. When we were playing the test series in South Africa, after a couple of tests, you know, people really thought that we were outplayed. And then we won the third, and then the series that followed happened. And then people really understood how well we played in that series. But we as a team internally knew we had played well, and that led to the success in the ODIs and the T20s as well, because we took the confidence into it. So people on the outside might not be able to see the small things that happen when you're playing a particular test match or a series. But the point you mentioned about teams not traveling well, I think we are one of the sides that are looking forward to going to other countries and playing. So I think that makes a massive difference, and that showed with the mindset of someone like Jasprit Bumrah, who was bowling 144 in his last spell of the third test. And that's where someone's point of fitness comes in. You know, when you have people that are hungry, that are fit, that are ready, you're not only competing, but you're winning. That's the difference between getting emotional and letting go of a policy and holding on to it and actually taking the hard calls and moving ahead with the system. So I think all those things have come together really nicely. And as I said, we're looking forward to playing difficult cricket. It can be anywhere, even in India. We're looking forward to playing difficult cricket because we feel that that is the only way we'll be able to test ourselves as a team and to be able to judge ourselves as players and as a team as well. So, as I said, it's a very exciting time for all of us.
See, looking forward, what Virat said, looking forward to playing, that is the key. You know, we want to play. I'm not too sure too many teams want to come to India.
Virat, hi. This is a question about your bowling unit. the fact that we are going to be, the bowlers are going to be bowling with the Kookaburra balls and not going to be playing with the Duke balls, do you think that's going to be an advantage for the Indian bowlers, considering, you know, we've had a very long season of IPL with it and, you know, the Indian bowlers are now used to bowling with the Kookaburra balls?
Look, I mean, yeah, it is definitely a case of familiarity. I wouldn't deny that. Bowling with the Kookaburra ball is something that we're very used to, the white ball only, because red is going to be Duke's. But it doesn't really matter, because as I said, you know, if the pitches are similar to what you get all over the world, which is shorter formats, batting friendly, and people want to see runs and all that. What's been the difference for us is the two X factors in the middle overs. So we have actually been able to create flat wickets into exciting wicket taking wickets because of the variety we have in the attack. So from that point of view, I'm very excited to see these guys again bowling in conditions that might not assist them so much, but it's their skill in the wrist which did the job for them in South Africa. And I'm sure teams are thinking about it, because I'm sure, I know for a fact, with our bowlers in the middle overs, when it's a full 50 over game, you cannot go that hard for 20 overs from two bowlers in a row when you know that they can get you out in any particular over that they bowl. So I think that's where the mindset changes, and that's what makes us excited about the attack that we have. I'm not denying that we have the fast bowlers to take wickets as well, but them being there after them gives fast bowlers even more confidence to attack even more. You know, they don't feel defensive at any point of time. So I think the combination is working really well, and it's given a great balance to the side.